how to activate an eSIM on any iPhone, step by step. First, open Settings, then select Mobile Service, then select Add eSIM. Select Use QR Code. This will activate the camera, so you have two options, to scan the QR code using the camera, or you can enter the details manually. I'll show you both methods. If you don't have an eSIM yet, you can use any provider, but I do recommend getting it from SIM Abroad. It's the most reliable service, they provide coverage in over 200 destinations, and they even have an eSIM that is global, so you need to install it once, and it supports over 138 countries. Now that you have your QR code, you'll need to print it or send it to another device in order to scan it with your camera. If you don't have another device, you can also select manual installation. This will display the SMDP address and activation code, which you can copy, then select enter details manually, and simply paste the address and activation code. I'll go back and scan my QR code from SIM Abroad. Now press continue, and it will connect to the network. Perfect, our mobile plan has been set up completely. Here, you will see all your mobile plans available. In this case, we have a primary line, and the second one is the eSIM that we just installed. These names can be a little bit confusing, so I recommend naming them according to your desire. Simply tap on the eSIM, and for this example, we will name it SIM Abroad eSIM. And there you have it, then tap continue. In case you have multiple eSIMs, you will need to select the one with the active data plan. We will select the one we just installed, SIM Abroad eSIM, and then tap Done. Perfect, now you can see that your eSIM has been successfully installed. Let's do the final steps. Tap on your eSIM from SIM Abroad, and then it's very important to activate data roaming. This will instantly activate your eSIM. Perfect, now we can see that the line is turned on, and everything seems to be working fine. Now let's tap on data mode. Here you will get three options. Allow more data on 5G, that's faster and that's recommended for streaming. Then we have standard and low data mode, but the data might be slower. The faster the speed, the higher the consumption data. So for now, we'll leave it at standard. If this is your second line and you're traveling, I recommend turning off data roaming on your primary line, just so that you're sure that they won't charge you. If you want to take this a step further, you can turn off the line fully. However, you won't be able to receive text messages and calls on your primary line. So I'll just leave this line activated and make sure that data roaming is turned off. And that's it. That finalizes the whole setup. Now I'm going to show you how to track how much data you have. Now that we have internet connection, we're going to open Safari. We're going to go to SIM Abroad, go to My eSIM, and you will see that the eSIM has been successfully activated. And you can also see how much remaining data we have. And that's it. Our eSIM has been successfully activated. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I hope that you enjoy your eSIM. Have a safe trip.